Welcome back on Transgroom TV. Today we talk about the double thinning season. What is a double thinning scissor? On both sides, the scissor have teeth. So this scissor is shaped or designed not for scissoring, but for thinning out. If you scissor one time with the scissor, you take 10% of the hair out. For example, if you have a golden retriever and here it's too thick and you want to make it smoother and not that thick anymore, you can use a double thinning scissor. What you have to do with this scissor is you comb the coat, and when you see it's too thick, you put in the scissor on the coat and you scissor one, two times. You take off the scissor, you comb, and you see that 20% of the coat is out of the coat. So you don't make it shorter with the double thinning scissor, you just make it smoother and less thick. That's the reason why the double thinning scissor is designed. Don't use a double thinning scissor on really fine coats. So you can use it on a cocker, like an English cocker, on a commercial English cocker, when you shave or when you scissor the dog, like a golden retriever, like a labradoodle, like a border collie. Please be aware, if you use a double thinning scissor on double coated breeds like a golden retriever, a border collie, an English cocker, that you don't mess up the coat on long-term base. Because if you scissor in the undercoat, it will give you curls and you will mess up the coat. You can do that one time, like for a show dog. A lot of breeders do that and it's fine, it's okay. But if you use it on a golden retriever in your grooming shop, and the next time he will come back, he will probably have curls. So be aware, if you use this scissor, don't use it too much on double coated breeds. Thank you for watching for the double thinning scissors. If you have any questions about dog care, pet care, coat care, or any other topics, please don't hesitate to contact us. That was Kitty for Transgroom TV. See you next time.